Did you people volunteer or were you chosen?
Volunteer.
And what kind of training did you have to have?
We went to various naval schools initially for theoretical training, and then
okay.
we sailed on board the first class
ocean. So you had to be champion swimmers as well,
different pilots,
all that?
Yes, ma'am, to some extent.
Are we done?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Congratulations. Come, shall we have a group picture with all your awards? Bring the awards.
Come.
Navika Sagar Parikrama was the conceptualization of retired Vice Admiral Manohar Awati. He is now in his 90s and he has been pushing this idea of circumnavigation of the globe since a very long time. The Navy finally accepted the idea, and in 2009 we saw the first solo circumnavigation by an Indian, which was undertaken by Captain Dilip Donde, now retired from the Navy. And the second one was in 2013 when Commander Abhilash Tomy, he undertook the first non-stop solo circumnavigation. Thereafter came the idea of having women officers from the Navy to undertake a similar expedition around the globe. And that's how the Navy pushed the idea. We, six of us, volunteered for the project, and we underwent training in various naval schools on seamanship, communication, navigation. We started training from the scratch. We didn't know anything about this, about sailing or sailboats before we actually joined for this expedition. When we underwent various sub-courses, we undertook hands-on training on the first of a class vessel, which was Madhei, on which Captain Dilip Donde had gone round the world. So that boat became sort of a training ground for us. We took that boat to Mauritius. We took the boat to Vizag and back on our own, independently. And we also took the boat to Mauritius twice and then to Cape Town. As and when we started sailing, gradually we got more confidence on our own sailing skills. And then we got the confidence that we can take the boat around the world. So then Tarini was inducted in 2016. And thereafter, we took Tarini for various sea trials to Porbandar and to various other ports around the Indian Peninsula. And thereafter, we also took her to Mauritius and back. And then on 10th of September 2017, Honorable Raksha Mantri Ji, she came to cast us off for the expedition. The expedition was divided into was meant for four stopovers. The first stopover was in Fremantle, Australia, which was almost a distance of almost 5,000 nautical miles of sea distance. We covered that in 41 days time. This leg came as an eye opener for us because we encountered winds of over 45 knots, which is close to 90 kilometers per hour, and sea state as high as 5. Waves as high as 5 to 6 meters. Thereafter, the second stopover was to New Zealand, Lyttelton, where we had to cross the Tasman Sea, and this was supposed to be one of the roughest passages in the entire voyage. When we reached Lyttelton, New Zealand, we were given a very warm welcome by the localites, and we also had the opportunity to interact with the local populace, the students there in various schools. We set off on the next long voyage across the Pacific Ocean to Falkland Islands. This entire stretch was almost 5,500 nautical miles long, 5,500 nautical miles is close to 10,500 kilometers, and we did not have any, there is no landmass in between in the entire stretch of the South Pacific Ocean. So the winds are supposed to be very, very strong there, and the seas are very high. The sea state is always very high, and there is one storm passing every 5 days or so. So we timed our voyage accordingly, and we made sure that we didn't have to encounter so many storms. There was one storm which actually came on our way, and we maneuvered the boat so that we can come out of the eye of the storm, and we skirted out of at the outer edge of the storm and maneuvered the boat accordingly. The storm gave us winds of about 60 hurricane force winds of 60 knots, which is close to 120 kilometers per hour, and the waves were as high as 8 to 9 meters high. That was the scariest part of the voyage, where the storm was passing for almost 19 to 20 hours at a stretch, and all six of us were on deck manning the boat, and we had to steer the boat to keep her on course and to avoid her getting overpowered. We had to cut short on the area of the sails. There is a mainsail on this particular boat, where the sail needs to be cut short when the wind speeds go up. So we had to cut short the sail. We brought her down on the last, on the smallest sail which we could ever have on the boat, and then we steered the boat towards Falkland Islands. In this entire stretch of, in this duration of the storm, there was also one, there were waves which were splashing on the boat, and all of us had to work when everything was wet inside and in very, very cold climatic conditions. The temperatures frequently fall to sub-zero, and there are hailstorms coming every 2 days or so. So that is very, very common in those parts of the world. We hardly saw any traffic also in between. There was no other vessels. Normally we are very, very far away from any shipping lanes. So we didn't encounter any other vessel on our way, and we maneuvered the boat towards Falkland Islands. We crossed Cape Horn, which is the southernmost point of our voyage, on 18th of January 18. That is the Cape Horn, which is also known as the Everest of the oceans, and is supposed to be one of the roughest parts on this planet. So we crossed that on 18th of January, and we were received by the governor of Falkland Islands thereafter, when we successfully made it to Falkland Islands. We received a very warm welcome from the local community there, and it's a very small place, and very, very heartwarming people reside there. Over a short duration of almost 12 days, and soon we were set off for our next stop over towards Cape Town, which is South Africa. This leg took us almost 25 days to reach South Africa across the Atlantic Ocean, where from the south, now we were returning back to the north, more towards more northeast. From the furious 50s, we came to the roaring 40s, as what they call, to the 30 degree latitudes. So the 60s, 50s, 40s, these are the latitudes which I am mentioning here. And then we made our way towards Cape Town. In Cape Town, we had a halt of almost 12 days, wherein we met the High Commissioner of India at Cape Town, Mrs. Ruchira Kamboj. And we made it on the day of Holi there, and we had a great welcome there. Our next final stopover was towards India. And we had to set off for India, but just 2,000 miles short of coming home, disaster struck when we had our steering gear breaking down. This forced us to make a detour towards the nearest port, which was Port Louis, Mauritius. We had to make some makeshift arrangements and temporarily make some arrangements so that we can fix the broken system and we can steer the boat safely towards Port Louis. On arrival at Port Louis successfully, after 3 days and covering over a distance of 180 nautical miles, it took us 3 days to reach. We were making hardly any speed, and we were using the shortest sail possible so that we do not at any given time we are not stressing the equipment on board. So we maneuvered the boat towards Port Louis, and we undertook emergency repairs there. And after 4 days, we got the entire system rectified, and we were set off for our journey back home. We resumed our circumnavigation towards India. In this entire circumnavigation, I would like to mention that there are certain criteria. You have to cross the equator twice. You do not have to use any auxiliary propulsion system. So we do have a small engine on board, but we can't use it. It is used only for entering and leaving harbor. We have to cross the three great capes, which are Cape Leeuwin, Cape Horn and Cape of Good Hope, and we needed to go south of all the three great capes. And then we need to start and end at the same port. So we started from Goa and we needed to end our journey at Goa itself. On the 21st of this month, we landed at Goa, and Honorable Raksha Mantri ji was again there to receive us. It was very, very great to have such a great welcome, where the entire country is wishing for you and praying for your well-being and safety. So I would like to thank each and everyone in the nation who were there supporting us when we were going through the roughest seas, and who stood by us, and they were supporting us with their prayers and well wishes.